Welcome to my video tutorial on histology of liver. Liver is composed of stroma and parenchyma. Stroma is nothing but connective tissue which forms capsule, trabeculae and reticular network. Parenchyma consists of hepatocytes, blood vessels and bile ducts, which form intrahepatic part of biliary apparatus. So basically, microstructure of liver is all about stroma and parenchyma. Let's see the features of stroma. It forms a fibrous capsule around the liver known as Glisson's capsule, which completely invests the liver. Around the porta hepatis, Glisson's capsule thickens and sends trabeculae into the parenchyma of liver, so that the parenchyma is divided into lobules. Within the lobules, type 3 collagen fibers known as reticulin fibers are seen around the sinusoids. So basically, stroma is nothing but connective tissue which forms fibrous capsule, trabeculae and reticulin fibers in the liver. Now let's see the features of parenchyma of liver. It is mainly composed of hepatocytes or liver cells, which are polyhedral cells, hexagonal in shape, having one or two spherical nucleus with a prominent nucleolus. They constitute 80% of liver volume. Here is the hematoxylin and eosin stained tissue showing a hepatocyte with hematoxylin-stained spherical nucleus, eosin-stained cytoplasm and cell wall. Hepatocytes are arranged as one-cell-thick layers or plates of liver cells, which are separated by sinusoids. Here is the HND-stained liver tissue showing hepatocytes' arrangement as single-cellular plates. The plates of liver cells anastomose with each other, separated by larger gaps known as sinusoids. Each hepatocyte shows six surfaces. The plasma membrane of these surfaces belong to three domains structurally. They are sinusoidal domain, where a portion of plasma membrane related with adjacent sinusoids, and it shows microvilli into perisinusoidal space. 70% of plasma membrane belongs to sinusoidal domain. Canalicular domain, where only 15% of plasma membrane involved in the formation of bile canaliculus with adjacent hepatocyte. Intercellular domain, rest of the plasma membrane between canalicular domain and sinusoidal domain forms intercellular gap junctions, which belong to 15% of plasma membrane. Here is the HND stained slide under high power showing hepatocytes with intercellular domain here and canalicular domain here. The most of the surface belongs to sinusoidal domain. Now let's see the next component in parenchyma of liver, blood vessels. They are hepatic sinusoids, hepatic artery and portal vein. Hepatic sinusoids, they are slit-like spaces separating plates of liver cells. They are lined by fenestrated endothelium, which is composed of endothelial cells, larger hepatic macrophages known as Kupffer cells. These cells are not supported by basement membrane, but reticulin fibers are seen between endothelium and hepatocytes. Occasionally, pit cells may be found adherent to the endothelial cells. They are large granular lymphocytes. So there are three types of cells found in hepatic sinusoids: endothelial cells, which form fenestrated endothelium, Kupffer cells, larger macrophages of liver and pit cells, large lymphocytes. Here is the hepatic sinusoid with fenestrated endothelium, Kupffer cells and pit cells. There lies a narrow space between sinusoid and sinusoidal surface of adjacent hepatocytes. Such space is known as perisinusoidal space or space of Dissi, which consists of reticulin fibers and eitocells or hepatic stellate cells. They store hepatic vitamin A and produce type 3 collagen and growth factors. Here is the HND stained liver tissue showing space of Dissi between hepatocyte and sinusoidal endothelium. These are endothelial cells and here is the larger Kupffer cell. The space of Dissi consists of eitocells, which are also called as lipid cells. They produce type 3 collagen or reticulin fibers into space of Dissi. The other blood vessels seen in parenchyma of liver are hepatic artery and portal vein. So the liver has dual blood supply. 75% of nutrient-rich blood comes from portal vein, whereas 25% oxygenated blood comes from right and left hepatic arteries. Both the vessels enter the liver at porta hepatis. Here is the portal vein. Blood from portal vein passes through hepatic sinusoids. From there, it enters a vein called central vein. Here is the hepatic artery, which give rise to distributing arterioles, which further divides into inlet arterioles to form peribiliary capillary plexus within the liver parenchyma. From the plexus, inlet venules arise, which continue as distributing venules, which further open into hepatic sinusoids. So the blood from portal vein and hepatic artery passes through hepatic sinusoids and enter central vein. Central veins unite to form sublobular vein, which unite to form collecting veins. Collecting veins form hepatic veins, which open into inferior vena cava. So the blood from hepatic arteries passes through hepatic veins and open into inferior vena cava. Let's see the other component of parenchyma of liver, bile ducts. Bile is secreted by hepatocytes, so the bile ducts begin around the hepatocytes at their canalicular domain in the form of bile canaliculi, which are intercellular spaces with a diameter of 1 micrometer. They are formed by adjacent surfaces of 2 or 3 hepatocytes. Here are the bile canaliculi formed at canalicular domains of hepatocytes. They unite to form intralobular bile ductules or canals of Herring, which further unite to form interlobular bile ducts or cholangioles, which open up into larger intrahepatic bile ducts. The intralobular and interlobular bile ducts are lined by cuboidal epithelium, whereas the larger intrahepatic bile ducts are lined by columnar epithelium. So the different sets of bile ducts seen in liver parenchyma form intrahepatic biliary apparatus. Narrow ducts lined by cuboidal epithelium, whereas larger ducts lined by columnar epithelium. So the microstructure of liver composed of stroma and parenchyma. Stroma is nothing but connective tissue which forms capsule of the liver and sends trabeculae into the parenchyma, so that parenchyma is divided into lobules. Parenchyma is composed of hepatocytes, blood vessels and bile ducts. Let's see the parenchyma of liver with hematoxylin and eosin stain. Here are the hepatocytes arranged in single cellular layers, which anastomose with each other and separated by sinusoids, which open into central vein. Hepatocytes form 70% of parenchyma. Here are the blood vessels and bile ducts. These are the three major components of parenchyma. Trabeculae divide the liver parenchyma into lobules. Lobules can be classified structurally and functionally into three types: classical lobules, portal lobules, and hepatic acinus or acinus of Rapoport. Let's see the histological features of these lobules. Classical lobule can be defined as a portion of liver parenchyma surrounded by fibrous tissue, centered by central vein with radiating hepatocytes, separated by sinusoids. It is hexagonal in shape, having six angles. At each angle, three structures passes through the fibrous tissue. They are portal venule, hepatic arteriole, and hepatic ductule. Such collection of three structures known as portal triad, seen at each angle of classical lobule, which consists of portal venule, hepatic arteriole, and hepatic ductule. Under high power of HND stained tissue, portal venule can be identified by its endothelium and larger lumen. Hepatic arteriole can be identified by endothelium, smaller lumen with thick eosin stained wall. Hepatic ductule can be identified by its cuboidal epithelium with narrow lumen. Here are the portal triad structures, which are separated from the classical lobule by a layer of hepatocytes, which form limiting plate, so that the structures run in a canal known as portal canal. Within the portal canal, there lies a narrow space surrounding the portal triad structures, known as portal space or space of Mall. Blood flows in a classical lobule centrifugally from periphery to the center towards central vein, whereas bile secreted by the hepatocytes flow peripherally towards interlobular or intrahepatic bile ducts. Let's see the features of portal lobule. It's a portion of liver parenchyma includes three adjacent classical lobules. It is centered by portal triad. It's a triangular shaped lobule having a central vein at its each angle, so that blood flows from center to periphery towards central vein, whereas bile secreted by all the hepatocytes in portal lobule flow towards the center into an interlobular bile duct. Hepatic acinus or acinus of Rapoport. It's a portion of liver parenchyma seen between two adjacent classical lobules, between two central veins. It is centered by a distributing artery. Depending on the arterial supply to the adjacent hepatocytes, the hepatic acinus divide into three concentric regions. The outermost region is zone 3, which is close to central vein and poor with oxygen. The remaining portion of the acinus divide into zone 2 and zone 1. Zone 1 is close to the artery, richest in oxygen. So the hepatic acinus is nothing but a portion of liver parenchyma seen between two central veins, centered by a distributing artery. It has three concentric zones. Zone 1 is close to blood vessels, zone 2 intermediate zone, zone 3 is adjacent to central vein. So the lobules of liver parenchyma are classical lobule, portal lobule, and liver acinus. In classical lobule, central vein is seen in the center, Peripherally, portal triads are seen. In portal lobule, central veins are placed peripherally, whereas portal triad seen in the center. In liver acinus, central veins are placed peripherally, distributing artery is in the center. Blood flow in classical lobule is centrifugal in direction, whereas in portal lobule and hepatic sinus, it is centripetal in direction. Bile flow in classical lobule, centripetal in direction, whereas in portal lobule, it is centrifugal in direction. Now it's time to see the liver tissue under low power with hematoxylin and eosin stain. Here is the central vein with the radiating hepatocytes and sinusoids. Here are the portal triads showing a portion of classical lobule. Portal triad structures can be identified under high power as a larger lumened portal venule, a thick eosin stained hepatic arteriole, and cuboidal epithelium lined bile ductule. Here is the HND stained liver tissue under low power, showing central veins more prominently. Portal lobule can be identified by joining the adjacent three central veins. Now let's learn how to draw the histology of liver diagram with HND stain. It should be drawn with hexagonal shaped classical hepatic lobules. Each lobule should be surrounded by eosin stained fibrous septa with fibroblast nuclei at its each angle, showing three structures of portal triad. They are larger lumen portal venule, it should be drawn with its endothelium, narrow lumen hepatic arteriole with thick eosin for its wall lined by endothelium. Bile ductule should be drawn with its cuboidal epithelium and narrow lumen. Within the lobule, central vein should be drawn at the center with its endothelium and larger lumen. It should be surrounded by radiating polyhedral hepatocytes forming single cellular layers. The layers should be anastomosing with each other, separated by larger gaps, hepatic sinusoids. Each hepatic sinusoid should be shown as lined by endothelium. These are the identification features of hepatic lobules, liver parenchyma, and stroma. Thanks for watching. Keep learning.